Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents The Art of Letting Go, edited by Thought Catalog, narrated by Tanya Eby. 1. Rania Naim. Letting go is really hard, especially when you have to let go of something you really want, whether it's an opportunity, or someone you really liked or loved, or even any expectations you had about something. I don't think anyone knows how to completely let go, or not fall back from time to time if they do. But there are definitely ways to make it easier for you to let go when you relentlessly don't want to let go. 1. What is destined will reach you, even if it be underneath two mountains. What is not destined will not reach you, even if it be between your two lips. Proverb. Anything that feels forced or harder than it should be or causes you pain and distress is not meant for you. Having this mentality or faith will help you overcome the reluctance that comes with making a decision of whether or not you should let go. Things that are meant for you have a way of flowing smoothly into your life. The more you fight for something that is not meant for you, the more it will fight you. You may get what you want in the end, but it may not last, and you may not feel at ease with it. The beauty of things that are meant for you is that they just happen, against all odds. We are just programmed to complicate life sometimes. 2. The only thing more unthinkable than leaving was staying. The only thing more impossible than staying was leaving. Elizabeth Gilbert. Letting go is really painful when you feel stuck, and it can sometimes seem impossible to do. But the truth is, if you reach this point, it means that you've been trying so hard to make this thing work in your favor or reach your goal, and it sometimes feels like we've tried so hard or come a long way that if we let go now, it will feel like a waste of time given the time and effort we invested in it. But nothing is a waste of time, even if it feels like it. We are here to make mistakes and learn lessons to grow as individuals. If we keep holding on to toxic situations or toxic people because we've already done too much or it's too late to change things, we are only setting ourselves up for a miserable life. There is power in letting go, a power that brings more peace and serenity than being stuck in situations that make your heart a bit heavier each and every day. 3. If you're brave enough to say goodbye, life will reward you with a new hello. Paulo Coelho. This outlook really helps you move on and let go faster. Same notion that when one door closes, another opens. Life opens new doors for you all the time. Imagine you are a key to multiple doors, and you just think you can only open one door. We have so much potential, so many talents, so many kind things to give back to the world. We have so many keys to open so many doors. When you leave one door behind and lock that door, you will be surprised by the number of doors that are waiting to be opened by you and only you. Some endings are not bad. Sometimes they are not even endings, just bridges to new beginnings. 4. I think part of the reason we hold on to something so tight is because we fear something so great won't happen twice. Anonymous. Here's another reason why we hold on to things or people longer than we should. We convince ourselves that good things won't happen twice. We will not be able to find someone who is that great again, or who makes us feel this way again. Or we won't be able to find a job like that again, or something we are that passionate about again. The truth is, you will always find something or someone that makes you feel this way again. New passions will emerge, and good things will happen twice, and as many times as they want, and will probably be a better and more convenient fit for you. If you look back at your life, you will find yourself laughing at certain situations when you thought you would never move on, or how you held on to something so tightly. Great things happen to us all the time in different shapes or forms. We just like to focus on the things that are not so great. Holding on to something out of fear that it will never happen again is the definition of fear. We have to be fearless in letting go. 5. See it for what it is, not what you want it to be. Anonymous. The truth is, if you reach a point where letting go is the only option, it usually means that this thing or someone already let you go. You are trying to stay in a place where you are not welcome anymore. The mind has a funny way of tricking us into believing certain things to make it less painful for us, or put it in a way that doesn't really hurt our pride or break our heart. But we have to look at it the way it is, the way it is being portrayed to us, not the way we want to see it. This is not an optical illusion. This is reality. And in reality, what you see is what you get. If an opportunity passed you by, it didn't really want to stop at your station. If someone let you go, they didn't really want to stay. If someone else got what you were praying for, this blessing was not written for you to begin with, and you will be blessed in another way. As you keep learning the art of letting go, let go of your fear, of your past, of your mistakes, of your insecurities, of your failures, of your self-doubt. Forgive yourself enough to let go of even the parts of you that dim your light. 2. 13 Things to Remember When You Realize He's Not Right for You. Skyla Child. I've always believed that it's easier to be hurt than it is to hurt someone else. I have told myself so many times, he's the right guy for someone, just not the right guy for me. As long as I can remember, I thought that being in a relationship for a few years means you are destined to be lifelong partners. It's only recently that I discovered this isn't true. I know that I can't be the only one in this situation, so for those who need it, cheers to the following lessons learned. 1. I've learned that no matter how long you've been together, when you know, you know. It's entirely possible to be with someone for 5 years, yet still not be right for each other permanently. 2. You don't meet people by accident, and that each person who crosses your path brings life lessons to you that God knew you needed. Everyone you meet makes you stronger, and makes you look at life just a little different than you did before. 3. Count on your family. For years I've considered my significant other my constant, which is true to an extent, but I've learned that your true constant throughout life is the family that God blessed you with. Never forget who you are and where you come from. 4. Don't lose who you are, even if you don't know yourself yet. In life, we are constantly reinventing ourselves. But don't give up things you once loved and sacrifice your independence. 5. It's hard to let go, but it's harder to be unhappy. Some happiness is only temporary, and sometimes making a hard decision requires you to find happiness that isn't. 6. A relationship should bring out the best in you. A relationship should be eternally supportive, and you should lift each other up in your worst moments. 7. Mistakes help us find the right person in the long run. Mistakes help you grow and be better for the next person that you share your heart with. 8. Read quotes and listen to lots of music. I can't tell you how many times reading endless quotes on the internet lifted my spirits and gave me clarity. Music has been my savior through so many challenging times. 9. You have to truly love yourself inside and out before you can be in a successful relationship. We learn to love ourselves more and more each day through growth. Making our own independent decisions without seeing them through someone else's eyes helps us to find out who we truly are. 10. Life gets better. Sometimes it's hard to see past tomorrow or next week. It's easy to get caught up in this moment and think about how bad it is without realizing that with time, things will start to look up for you again. 11. Open your eyes to every opportunity. You never know what could change your life next. Sometimes being in a relationship can fog your choices, but it's important to take opportunities that will help you grow. 12. Be brave.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.